Flash forward to 2020, Amber is a four-time Golden Guitar winner and has well and truly cemented herself as one of Australia's leading country chicks. Aussie country music star Amber Lawrence joins us now from our courtyard in Sydney. Good morning, beautiful Amber. Now, right now you're perched on a park bench outside Channel 10, but you recently broadcast an entire concert from a picnic bench in Coogee. Exactly. How was it performing without a physical audience?
Well, I'm getting so used to it now. It's nearly 6 months for musicians where our business was pretty much shut down that second week of March. And straight away I was behind the computer screen and performing to audiences. And it's so different when there is no reaction when you finish a song and the reaction is silent, or it might be someone typing saying, loved that, please play this song. So we've just learnt to really adapt. And honestly, the online concerts, you put as much into them and as much energy, and they're just as exhausting as actually being in front of people. And I did one outdoors, as you say, and people were walking past, stopping, having a look, but I think people were worried, like, am I allowed to stay and watch? You know, what are the rules? So who knows? But yeah, it's been a different time.
Amber, 2020 has been particularly painful for you and your husband, Martin. At the end of July, you revealed you lost your son, Edward, through stillbirth halfway through your pregnancy. I'm so sorry, and all of the Studio 10 family are sending you our deepest sympathies. How are you and Martin now?
Thank you. Look, we're okay. You know, time certainly has helped heal, and I think late in July, and it was 4 weeks after we'd lost Edward, or Woody as we call him, I made a statement. I went straight to Facebook and straight to Instagram because it was really impossible for me to get back to being the standard happy person that I am without telling everyone what we'd been through, because early COVID lockdown, we were so excited. We kept it a secret. You know, we were having a baby, and we thought we were going to come out with this baby once we all got out of lockdown. And then halfway through my pregnancy, we got terrible news, and I couldn't just go back to being me without sharing the news. And there was that element, but there was also, I wanted other women to know that it happens to everyone, because when it happened to me, I just needed to hear about other stories to know that I would be okay. So we're doing okay.
Well, that's very good to hear. And looking at that photograph of you cradling, your son is so poignant.
Yeah.
So poignant. I know you had a farewell ceremony for him. How else will you honour Woody?
Well, I guess everyone assumes that I'll write a song eventually, and I think because I'm deep down that path now of losing a baby or miscarriage or having people talk to me about it all the time now because I have revealed that about myself, it's probably something that I would do going forward, you know, if the emotions hit me and the words come to me, to honour all lost babies, no matter when in the pregnancy it happens. So there's nothing on the paper yet. There's nothing that's hit me as being that special song, but I do tend to write about what happens to me, so I guess in a year or two I probably will.
Throughout all of this, you and your husband have been busy raising your two-year-old son, Ike, who I imagine is the light of your lives.
Well, he's the light of our lives, but goodness me, you've had a two-year-old too, Anne.
Yeah, I have, you're right.
So he certainly, he's put everything back into perspective. You know, he is extremely energetic and extremely fast. So I'm on my toes all the time. If we go for a walk, we're not walking, we're running. And, you know, we are so lucky. We know that we have a beautiful, healthy two-year-old, and he is going to, you know, he'll give us his money's worth.
And Amber, we were talking about the perils and pitfalls of online dating earlier in the show, and you actually met your husband on Tinder in 2016. What made you swipe right?
I know. Is it right or left? I can't remember. Yeah, I haven't been on for a few years now. It was just a kind-looking face, and also the fact that he looked really normal. He wasn't posing with huge muscles or huge tattoos everywhere, or he wasn't cradling a tiger. So that was like, oh, he's in. Yeah. Swipe right.
So that's how it goes, guys. I told you, no eggplant pics.
You are, of course, always such an amazing singer. We love hearing you sing. You've got this version of True Blue with Elise Simmons, Christy Lee Akers, Diana Corcoran that's had 1.4 million Facebook views. But now we are going to have something from you live. You're going to play us an acoustic version of Heart, which is the second single off your album Spark. And if you want to order Amber's latest release, head to her live, that's her live DVD album, head over to her website, amberlawrence.com.au. Amber, thanks so much for joining us today.
Thanks.
Take it away.
You got heart big enough to light the dark, a little pretty little spark. Yeah, that's what's gonna take you far. You got heart even when you fall apart. You pick yourself right back up. That's what makes you who you are.